If you're getting a Roku error code 500, you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix this issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Power cycle the Roku device. When you are getting Roku error code 500, power cycle the Roku device. Unplug the Roku from power for 30 seconds, then plug it back in. This can help clear any temporary glitches or issues. Check your network connection. The next thing you can do is ensure your Roku device has a stable internet connection. You should also check the internet speed on another device like your PC by visiting speedtest.net. If the internet speed is low, you can contact your service provider to fix the issue. Method 2. Restart the router or modem. Try restarting your router or modem and make sure the Roku is close enough to the wireless router. To restart Roku, unplug the modem or router from the power outlet. Wait at least for a couple of minutes. Then turn on the router or modem. Method 3. Check the channel or app status. The Roku error code 500 is typically caused by issues with the specific channel or app you are trying to add using a code, rather than a problem with the Roku device itself. The error 500 is often caused by issues with the specific channel or app you are trying to use. You can contact the channel or app provider to see if they are aware of any outages or problems with their service. Method 4. Clear your cache and data. From the home screen, press the home button on the remote 5 times, then press the up arrow button. Now, press the rewind button twice, and then press the fast forward button 2 times. Wait for Roku to restart. Temporary data called cache and cookies can get corrupted and take more space over time, so they cause unexpected issues. This process should clear the cache on Roku TV, and by doing that, you make sure you can prevent additional problems. Method 5. Reinstall the app or channel. If the channel or app provider confirms there are no known issues, try removing and reinstalling the channel or app on your Roku device. This can help resolve any corrupted installation files. To reinstall a channel, follow these steps. Perform a system restart on your Roku device before reinstalling the channel. Go to the Roku home screen, use the arrow buttons to find the channel. Press the star key on your remote to open the channel options menu. Select Remove Channel and confirm the removal. Restart your Roku device to ensure the changes take effect. Now, go to the Roku home screen. Select Streaming Channels from the left sidebar. Search for the channel. Select the channel and click Add Channel. If prompted, enter your PIN or confirm the installation. Click OK to confirm. If the channel requires login credentials, you may need to sign back in after reinstalling. Method 6. Check for system update. The next thing you can do is update your Roku software. An outdated system version can be responsible for triggering such errors. To update the Roku, head to Settings. Select System. Select Software Update. Confirm if prompted. Wait for the process to complete. Wait till the system installs the latest updates. Once done, you can restart the system and check. Method 7. Factory reset the Roku. The next thing you can do is factory reset your Roku device. This will erase all your settings and channels. So be sure to note down any important information first. Try performing a factory reset or hard reset on the device to clear any cached data or settings that may be causing the update issue. To do that, open Settings, then navigate to System. Next, select Advanced System Settings. Select Factory Reset. Enter the number and follow as shown to finish the process. Wait for the device to restart. Method 8. Contact Roku. If the issue is not resolved after performing the methods shown in this video, you can check the Roku community for help. Users might have faced similar issues and have suggestions. And there you have it. The methods to fix error code 500. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.